This video is brought to you by SailRite. Visit SailRite.com for all your project supplies, tools, and instructions. An overlapping seam is often used in sail making and some canvas work, especially when sewing awnings, canopies, and some covers. It's the easiest seam to create and sew. Here is a Sunbrella marine grade fabric that we will use as a sample to demonstrate the seam. Using a soapstone pencil, we will mark the cut line and then our seam allowance line, in this case, a half inch. If edges are scissor cut, they may unravel, but if cut with a hot knife, raveling will almost be totally eliminated. Here we are using the Sailrite Edge hot knife to cut the fabric in half. On the underside, we place the Sailrite tempered cutting glass, which protects the table from the hot knife and provides for a nice clean cut. The seam stick or double-sided tape is often used to baste panels together prior to sewing. Here we are using seam stick for canvas in a 3/8 inch width. Not only does this help hold panels in place, but if you sew through it, it can reduce water leaking through needle holes, making the seam more water resistant, and it reduces puckering issues when sewing. Now we can overlay the second panel directly on top of the seam line that we struck on the fabric with a soapstone pencil. To baste it down well, we'll press the seam together. We did this with the Sailrite canvas patterning ruler. To sew this canvas fabric, we will use a straight stitch, set it about 6 millimeters in length, and sew roughly an 1/8 inch away from the raw edge of the top panel. When you start to sew, do a little reversing to lock the stitch in place. To guide the stitch, we will line up the fabric's raw edge to a spot on the presser foot and try to feed the fabric nice and straight as we sew along this seam. The overlapping seam is easy to make and sew, and it's efficient when it comes to fabric usage. It also provides about 90% of the fabric's strength when double stitching is made in that seam. The cons of the overlapping seam is that it's not very water resistant when compared to other seams, and the top threads are always exposed to the sun. To sew the second stitch, we will flip the fabric assembly so we can see the opposite panel's raw edge and sew roughly an 1/8 inch from that edge, just as we did with the first stitch. And as always, do some reversing at the beginning and the end of your sewing to lock your stitch in place. The overlapping seam may be easy to make, but you should consider the fact that the needle holes go straight through the fabric from top to bottom, making it less water resistant. And that no matter what side is facing the sun, the threads are exposed to the elements, shortening their life unless a lifetime PTFE thread is used. With that said, this is still a popular seam that should be considered for awnings, canopies, and especially sails on boats where a flat profile seam is required, and if the fabric assembly is large, a more complicated seam may be difficult to make and sew. To see more videos on seam construction, click one of the video links here, or click the links in the YouTube description.